We're now going to look at charging a capacitor in more detail. The annotations that I have over here to the right are based on discussions we've already talked about. We've talked about what happens right at time t equals zero when the switch is closed and the battery begins to charge the capacitor. So I'm just looking at the battery as an EMF voltage. So at time t equals zero, to remind you, there is no charge on the capacitor. If there's no charge on the capacitor, then there's no voltage across the capacitor, right? Because Q equals CV. And there's no back voltage because the voltage on the capacitor provides the impedance to the flow of charge, so the current is a max. And then at time t equals infinity, when we are fully charged, the capacitor voltage has our full back voltage pushing back against the battery. The charge is at its max value based on CV. V is the full battery voltage. No current is flowing at this point. So in that branch of the circuit, the current is zero because the back voltage has shut it off. And the voltage across the resistor is now zero because, look, we've included a resistor in this loop of charge. So we're now taking a more realistic view of having some resistance in the circuit. So what we are going to do, as it shows here, is put a Kirchhoff voltage loop in during the charging process to fill in the gaps. Now we want to know what's going to happen between time t equals zero and fully charged t equals infinity. And to do that, we're going to look at our Kirchhoff voltage loop analysis. So if we look at this blue voltage loop, right, it's one current, so we don't need to worry about junctions or breaking the current up. Some of the voltage sources. Now, the battery is the only voltage source. The capacitor, that back voltage, will act as a voltage drop, so that's Q on C. And the voltage drop across the resistor is IR. So fundamentally, this is our loop equation. Sum of the voltage sources equals sum of the voltage drops. Now, the trick to solving it as a mathematical differential equation is to know that you need to change the I into a dQ dt. And then we're going to rearrange it a little bit mathematically into this form, which, as it says here, this is a differential equation that is going to describe charging a capacitor through a resistor R. So we're going to see on the next page of notes that the solution to this differential equation is given by this equality. And let's just take a look at what we have here. So we algebraically, we get the dq dt by itself by dividing out the R, right? So that's where the RC comes from. So to go from here to here really is just algebra. So when we're taking a look at the solution, what we're saying is that when we plug this in for Q and we take the derivative of this and plug this in here, we will get that equal to epsilon divided by R. So we are going to do this on our next page of notes, but before we go to there, just make sure that we totally understand the beginning, the end, and how the math works out to structure the middle part, and then this solution we'll address on the next page of notes. So look at this, and we need to discuss it before moving on to the solution if you have any questions.